came to Chicago. I used to work in the Chicago Children's Choir, is why I came to Chicago. And Erin's nephew was a member of the Chicago Children's Choir. So I've known her from those days. And through the years, we just simply have kept in touch. She even has given me the honor of being her organ teacher from time to time. So she calls me teacher, and I call her student. So Erin, I know that you're about to move into another phase of your life down in Georgia. So we put together a little something to honor you. So we're going to start off with, I will do a new thing. And then we will go from there, and I know two of your sort of favorite singers in the choir are Gail and Tania, and they will go into the hymn, Thy Way, not my will, but Thy will, O Lord, be done. And then you gave me a book that has the song, and the greatest not faithful, that makes me cry all the time. But I'm being smart today. I'm only going to do the last part of it and see if I can make it through. Amen. So we would, the choir will honor you and just remember you because you've been a wonderful supporter.
Amen.
For us.
Thank you.
need to say we're going to miss you. I always notice how you always take advantage of the flowers after service. I know you love to have some beautiful flowers on your table. I got you your own bouquet. That's right. Also, I want to send you away with this prayer book from the pews of St. Thomas. I know you love books. I know you have a collection of them. But this one, I hope you will hold in your heart as special. Because we send with this our prayers for you. That life from now on will be sweeter than it's ever been before.
Amen. Erin, this is a gift for you from all of us in PCW. We want to thank you for your literary gifts. We want to thank you for reminding us of where we come from so that we know where we're going. God bless you. Thank you.
The part that he didn't say was that I'm here because of him. He asked me to substitute one Sunday in June some years ago. And at that time, I had walked out of my church the Sunday before and said I will never come back here again. After 50 years there, I said I will never come back. Until I said I will never come back, nothing showed up to me. Once I gave it up, Keith asked me to come here. I came that Sunday and I never left. This has been the most satisfying. I'm glad that this is doing us here. It's so happy and supportive of my church experience that I'm here with you. And it ends my time in Chicago on such a happy note.
Amen. Erin, we actually have an additional gift for you that you'll be receiving in the mail.
Oh.
Wow.
Yes. I have put together a picture book for you. It's a memory book. It's a picture of, it has pictures of clergy, of St. Thomas, of the choir, and other members of St. Thomas, so it's something. It's still in the lab, so it's not ready. It's being prepared. So as soon as it's ready, we will get it to you.
Thank you so much.
Now, that those who's our prayer, birthdays, anniversaries, traveling, any other special attendance, and so please come forward to the staff. Yes,
the art ministry would like to thank everybody who came to view this exhibit last week. It's astounding, fabulous, it's great work. It's still open, it'll be up, I guess, for several months, so if you haven't seen it, please come and see it. It's great.
Yes.
The Polly and Esther campaign is